to my mom. He does this to me. Really wonderful.
Where is your granddad, Thomas? Where is granddad?
Yes. Chum chum. Chum chum. That's it.
That's posing.
Yeah. What's this?
Happy birthday, dear Dad. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
No, wait till Simon
can
tell you because he wants to
vote. Just cut. Cut away. Simon will take the photos as you go.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Grandad. Happy birthday to you. Hey!
Thomas, bravo, 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 bravo.
Molto bene, molto bene.
Bravo, bravo, bravo. Granddad, you have to blow the candles first.
Oh, blow the candles, ready?
Blow the candles.
Yeah.
Oh, big breath.
No. One, two, three.
Well done, Granddad.
Oh, man.
By mid-July, enough mines had been cleared to allow for the return of the submarine flotilla. Nevertheless, the civilian population were down to starvation ration level, and it was not until the arrival of the pedestal convoy in August that starvation and capitulation was avoided. On the 10th of August, the 14 merchant ships of convoy pedestal sailed from Gibraltar for Malta. They were all fast merchantmen, including the large British manned tanker Ohio. An escort force numbered 4 aircraft carriers, 2 battleships, 7 cruisers, and 24 destroyers. It was the most fiercely contested convoy of the Mediterranean campaign. Axis air resources totaling 540 aircraft were pitted against it, as well as the Italian cruiser squadron that had operated so effectively against Harpoon in June. First blood went to U-73 when he put 4 torpedoes into the Eagle and sank her north of Algiers. Fierce air battles took place overhead as the fighter screen attempted to keep the attacking dive bombers and the torpedo bombers from the convoy and its escorts. Italian submarines attacked and mortally hit the cruiser Cairo and damaged the cruiser Nigeria. Most importantly of all, one of the torpedoes tore a gaping hole in the side of the tanker Ohio and set it on fire. Initially deserted, it was then boarded again, the fire put out, and its crew coaxed it towards Malta. Ships and escorts endured dive bombing, E-boat attacks, and the threat of a surface attack from the Italian cruiser squadron. This turned back after being led to believe that they were about to be attacked by an RAF bomber force, only 2 cruisers having torpedoed Lieutenant Alistair Mars in the submarine Unbroken. On the 13th of August, the merchantmen Port Chambers, Rochester Castle and Melbourne Star sailed slowly into Valletta Harbour to the cheers of the population and garrison who crowded the battlemented walls of the port. 70 miles to the west, the battle-scarred Ohio, surrounded by a protective shield of destroyers and minesweepers, limped along at 4 knots. It was attacked again as it neared Valletta, and a 1,000-pound bomb burst under its stern, tearing another hole in its side. Slowly sinking, the Ohio was nursed into the Grand Harbour with its priceless cargo of 10,000 tons of fuel oil and kerosene. Malta was saved. Pedestal had cost 9 merchant ships, the carrier Eagle and 2 cruisers, but it was a strategic victory. It was the last convoy to Malta whose passage was seriously challenged. The re-equipping of Malta as an offensive base for aircraft and submarines saw a concerted attack on Libyan convoys. Guided by ultra-intelligence, the RAF sank 20,000 tons of Axis shipping in August 1942, the highest total since October 1941. In addition, British submarines sank 35,000 tons. These strikes combined sent 24% of Axis shipping capacity supplying North Africa to the bottom of the Mediterranean. Tobruk became too dangerous for Axis shipping, which was redirected to Tripoli and Benghazi, 1,350 and 500 miles respectively from Rommel's front line.
I say, how nice, how very nice. You never told me about the third stripe.
It's very recent.
All the same, Sergeant, jolly good.
Would you like a bacon sandwich?
A cold bacon sandwich?
I got them in Rampur last night, at the station restaurant.
Did you now? Then you ought to have a crown as well. All this?
After we'd had dinner, while you were with the men. It's a surprise breakfast. Have a hard-boiled egg first.
That too? No, I'll have a sandwich first. They taste better on the train. Something to do with the soot and the smoke. I've been taking a breather. First into the hills. In the old days, stop here, get up a hill of steam. 2 hours to Pangkot, if you stick to the time.
Tea all right, Daddy?
Not sweet. Remember our morning rides together? Must do that again soon.
Afraid I'm rather out of practice.
All the more reason. Thank you yet for all you've done for me while I've been away. Aunt Fanny told me what a brick you've been.
It wasn't anything.
Such a help to your mother and Susan. And coming to Bombay to meet me as well.
Oh, I enjoyed that.
It took rather longer than I expected, waiting until the last few men were fit to travel. Pity the chaps from prison camp couldn't have gone together.
They'll be so excited to see the hills.
Yes.
Look, you can see the men in the other coaches. Oh, they're waving.
Yes, there are the men.
Kevin, how are you?
Not so bad, sir.
Hello, Samad.
Good journey, had you?
Thanks, Captain Kevin.
Done everything you asked. Trucks for the men, staff car for you. Your driver's here.
I hope no one was disappointed. Not to turn out bad.
Oh, I think quite understood. No sort of fuss.
Well, I'll see the men get away first. We've got a few invalids. And your driver can take us home.
I think everything's laid on in the yard. Gentlemen, you've heard the latest, have you? Americans seem to have dropped some new kind of bomb. A place called Hiroshima.
Hiya, Shabash.
That's a view I remember. Everything seems closer together.
Perhaps Bangkok shrunk. Like your feet.
What?
You said the shoes I bought you felt too big.
Oh, yes. If you don't mind, I think I'll walk the rest. I'd prefer that.
Yes, of course.
All right. Muduroko.
Did a Taro job take mem sahib? Johnny Cage has had no data.
Give me a little time to cope. Say 5 minutes.
Of course.
Still smells the same, though. Wood smoke.